Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to my channel, Alto Channel, with me, Ali Tantowi. In this video, we are going to learn an important topic, which is very important in learning English. The topic in this video is about prefixes. Before we see some examples and the meaning of prefixes, we are going to see some important information about prefixes. The first one is about the definition. So what is the definition of prefixes? Prefixes can be defined as a group of letters we add to the beginning of a word. Prefixes are taken from letters that we add to the root words. For example, it can be I and M, im, U and N, an, I and R, ear, for example, ill, and many more. And then the second one, prefixes change the meaning of the words. So if we put a prefix in the beginning of a word, so the meaning of the word will be changing. And then the third one, understanding prefixes can expand our vocabularies and figure out the meaning of unknown words. So if we know some definition or some meaning of certain prefixes, we can guess the meaning of difficult words that use prefixes. And then let's see the meaning of prefixes. One of the meaning is opposite meaning or negative. Look at this. The first example is dislike. So the root word is like, and then if you put this in the beginning, so the meaning will be the opposite. So the meaning of dislike is hate. The second one is connect. Connect, for example, the internet connection, is connected, or I want to connect to the internet. But if you add this, the meaning will be the opposite, disconnect or disconnected, for example. And then agree has the same opinion. If you add this here, so the meaning will be different. And then unhappy, happy, the root word is happy. If you add un in the beginning, so the meaning will be the opposite, which is sad. And then the next one is possible, the root word is possible, and then if you add im, the meaning will be impossible. It is not possible to apply, for example. And then the last example is regular. So the meaning of irregular, not regular. And then the next one, one of the meaning of the prefixes is co. For example, here the meaning is together. For example, cooperate. So operate, of to function, to work. So if you add co, it become cooperate, like to work together. And then the next one, the meaning of prefix is again. For example, re. The example here, rewrite, to write again. And then the next one is multi. Multi, the meaning is many. For example, multi-purpose vehicle, multi-purpose tool. And then the next one, anti or anti, the meaning is against. For example, anti-war, that you are against war, you don't agree with war. And then the last meaning here, it can be across. So the suffix is trans. For example, transnational, so it's the activity between two countries or more than two countries. It's transnational. And then beside the previous meaning, there is also a specific use in prefix in forming modern terms. The first one is related with electronic, for example, e-book or e-cigarette. And something that is related with online, for example, e-content, the content of information that we can access on the internet, or e-commerce, or economic activity that we can do online. And then, for example, email also, that the mail that we can send online, that we can read online. And then the last one, E also can be involving electronic data transfer, especially over the internet, for example, e-banking, the banking activity that we have online that use internet data. Now we are going to see some practices how to use the prefixes. Okay, now the first one is perfect. So what is the suitable prefix for perfect? This is imperfect. The second one is social. The most used prefix for social is antisocial. The third one is media. The prefix is multimedia. And then the next one is view. The most used prefix for view is review. And then gender. Gender. The prefix can be trans, for example, transgender. And then the last one is worker. I think it is most used. For example, co-worker. Okay, I think that's all for this video. I hope that you can share this video. Then don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.